Welcome to Face It TV, guys, for our coverage of the GSL Egamingbets Cup. We have NIP coming up for the first game. They're going to be against MYM. And joining me for commentary today is none other than Thorin. So welcome, Thorin.
All right, mate. How's it going?
Not too bad. Curious to see how MYM are going to do against NIP. What are your thoughts?
Well, I mean, I obviously think NIP are going to trash them and stomp all over them and rip their
Indeed.
Family and destroy their village and burn it to the ground. But in the context of this game, it is online, so that does even it up a bit. And also, I don't think most people know much about MYM, actually. Like, the only player we really know is Lord, who used to be in the old Golden Five lineups of the Poles. It's like Neo, Taz, and all them, so...
All right, looks like we're actually jumping into the game. Sorry to interrupt you there, but the action awaits. So... we are coming up onto the pistol round, and it looks to be that NIP are stuck on Terrorist for the beginning of the match.
I mean, that's at least the side you'd want the best team to start on, so that potentially we can get some rounds for the Polish side on this half, and then it makes it a game, and then you can see what happens from there.
So Vivlerin leading the charge on the outside with Forrest, jumping across the silo on top of Main, going for the headshot. They're looking for that frag, and he does find it onto Kolitsky. So they've made a lot of ground on the outside now, and it looks like they're trying to get cute, the CTs. They're trying to push Radio, but Getroy's stopping them from entering lobby, so that's really going to hurt their rotation there through that lobby.
And Freeburg had already wrapped around the back as well, so now they're sort of trapped in the ramp area.
Great play from Fiffler in there. Very, very fast around, all the way around, as you said, the sandwich there. Looks like NIP are indeed walking all over them for the pistol round so far. And Freiburg getting a frag as well as Getright. It's looking like NIP, quick cleanup. It seems as if they just more or less just outplayed them completely. They just had their way with them on the execution battles and just took all the map control, and that was it.
Well, that's the key thing. It was total map control, because you saw when the CTs tried to push aggressively into the radio room, if there isn't a NIP player there, or if they kill him immediately, that's exactly the correct response to a really fast push outside, because then you can tell, did anyone go upper at all? If not, then we all go vents or we all go outside. But because they couldn't get any of that information, then they were just at the mercy of the NIP players as to where they pushed. And you saw that Getright sitting in the hut, he could have even just waited and killed that guy when he went down the vent. And so with no map control, you have no information. And on a pistol round, you have to be able to react really quickly if you're the CT.
Certainly, and NIP are getting like fairly aggressive on the anti-eco here as they're pushing down secret. And I love the play from Forrest, like buying the AK and using it on the silo. Of course, if he dies there, it's not really a risk of giving away the AK. And actually trying to make their way into the lower site, Freiburg having to get a revenge frag. But it should be fine for NIP as they take control of the lower site. But a few players here from MYM, the Poles ready and waiting. Good nade coming in from Freiburg, even gets the kill. It's just two players remaining now for MYM in the second round. And what can they do here? Not really much at all. Just a few pistols and that's it.
Well, I mean, on Nuke especially, it's very difficult to do anything on these CT halves. Like, unless you're some ridiculous team like a Titan who has, like, special abilities, it seems, on those eco rounds, then for everyone else, there's not a whole lot you can do. You just hope for a couple of kills. That's about it.
So we have some CZ-75s coming in for MYM as they try to just invest a bit in those pistols. What would you like to see MYM do here? You said perhaps use the special abilities of Titan, but do you feel like there's something MYM could be cute with?
The mistake I always think when you're on these eco rounds like this is to play really far off. You need to close the distance as much as you can. Like, you don't have to necessarily set up some perfect ambush, but you want to take all your fights so close range that at least you're potentially headshotting them all the time with the pistols.
And it's like actually they will take down Getroy there and steal away his Bison, but that weapon's not really going to cut it against the four AKs, armor, and head armor.
This is actually a mistake, I think, to push up like this.
Let's see if Michi can do anything with this, though. It's like NIP are just being steady now, holding their ground. They don't want to give away any more weapons, and they have all the time in the world.
He's going to kill this guy who had the gun here, so that's a waste of that weapon, and now his teammate can't even get to it because they separated. That's why it was a mistake to go up there, because you never want to give head height advantage away. In a CT, you can have head height advantage if you want all the time by just maintaining where you are on the map.
And it will be Kowalski to get one frag, but Pifferin will take him down. So, I mean, nothing really surprising happening on the pistol rounds there, or rather the ecos for MYM and NIP going three up. But we're going to see the first buy round, first gun round from MYM here. So it's going to be interesting to see what kind of defensive setup they're going to go with. How are NIP going to play this? They know that MYM have guns now. Are they going to get aggressive? Are they going to wait for picks? We're about to find out what they're going to choose here. I'd like to see Thoris going up on the silo again, I gotta say. So far, they're just taking it slow outside, just gaining some ground. And again, Getright just holding down lobby, it seems. So they are making committed push outside, onto Secret. Minai's with a good spray onto Fifferin, gonna take him down. Freiburg with the trade, though. And they're going to make their way all the way down Secret, even taking down Lord, who was in the window. Great shot from Forrest. Is Getright still holding kind of door and lobby area? So NIP, they've traded 2 kills for 1, and they've gained so much ground here, and they're already on the lower site with Getright in a great position to help them if need be from behind.
Well, the crucial thing is he's telling everyone that they can't be down the vents. They have to be going ramp area. And so if you're the guy lower, now he sees one. That gives you so much information, and now you're never worrying about someone popping out that vent, and you've killed everyone a secret anyway.
Freiburg going for the plant behind the smoke. Michu and Kowalski, the last ones remaining for MYM, as Freiburg is not alone, but with some stellar play, MYM might be able to do something here, but it's going to be Forrest to take down Michu. So it does go for the save, as you say, and a disappointing round for MYM, letting go outside there. It felt like, you know, that 2-1 trade.
He might get killed here, actually.
That was
really pointless to show there. That's an example for anyone who plays CS of where you have almost nothing to gain. Because if you get that one kill there, okay, congrats, you have $300 and the gun. But by dying, you lose the gun. You don't get the $300 anyway. You give him $300, and now you have nothing on your team. So you could have at least maybe got some eco frags or held one spot on this round. And instead, you risked it for what was essentially an unnecessary attack.
It's like a net loss of like 4k or something, basically.
That's actually something where people get mad when I point it out. But believe it or not, CS players don't understand what in poker we would call like expected value on certain players. Even some pro players.
And here we go.
It's because, you know, they're so good, they're thinking they're going to get the kill every time. But that's like, that would be a bad mentality to have in any sport. You're supposed to fundamentally try and do the correct strategy at each moment, because that all will add up and make you a better player in the long run.
Of course, it's one of those, I mean, unlike with poker, it's a very nice headshot there onto Exist. When he gets the gun inside, he's going to try to work as well. And he does manage to pick it up. That's quite brilliant. And now he's going to take down Getright with it as well. It's a 1-on-3, and the bomb is down, so the odds are heavily against.
He obviously should save his weapon again here, but I imagine he's probably going to just go and look for some kills. In this position, it's not as bad because you are going to have guns next round, I assume, anyway. And so, it's not quite as bad, but at the same time, that's also actually, just to highlight another mistake people make, which is, I noticed Eastern European teams have a mentality where they think, if we have a gun that we can afford to lose because we'll buy next round, it doesn't matter. But actually, again, if you're talking about the economy, it's better to have a gun's worth of money saved up and get the guns next round. So this time it's actually totally worked out because he's got 2 kills and got away. So that wasn't so bad. And if you notice, he took much better fights there than he did before when he was going blind out of the radio.
Definitely. So let's see now if they can turn this around, because it starts to get a bit grim at this point, especially with NIP on Terra's side. You know, 5 rounds already. MYM really need to bring things back at this point. They've got Minai's on an AWP. I imagine he'll be doing outside with that. Let's see if they can stop that from NIP, because that's where they've really been taking all the rounds. They've been getting such sick control outside and just been pushing.
Well, now Freiburg's going to push the ramp room as well, so he's really going to test what they're doing here to see if he can help the guy outside go further. And the guy outside's already over.
See if Freiburg can do much here. And actually, his teammates are ready to back him up as he goes in. The first man, the entry fragger, can he make it happen? Michu's behind him. There goes the train. Michu taking down 2, looking for some more here. Can he do it? Or will he's actually taken no damage so far. Exist falls as well. So 1 for 3 from Michu. They're brilliant plays. Just Getright and Fifflerin, who are left alive on the terrorist side, to try to take control of the situation. It's a 2 versus 3, and Getright's going to get this bomb down.
Kowalski's going to be in position to kill him immediately. So that was actually a really good aggressive play, because now it's passed back into their favor because the bomb is down.
Nice. Brilliant play there from MYM, and they did indeed get the round. They really need to get the next 9 rounds if they want to have any chance against NIP, who are already on paper heavily, heavily favored.
So the key play there was that it looked initially, if you were looking from NIP's point of view, like, okay, they've made a mistake. They haven't been fast enough on the rotation to below the ladder to stop us. But actually, the MYM guys wanted them to go lower because they already had people in position lower. And obviously, that's a bit fortuitous, the timing to go out while the guy's planting. But that's like a calculated risk that totally worked out in their favor, because as soon as you get that kill, you're now the one in position because you know where the bomb is and you know that the other CTs have to go to it, terrorists rather.
And Minaj just lost his AWP there for no gain at all. Complete waste of that AWP. And Fifflerin and Forest chiming in with a take down on two more players from the CT side. There's a trade at the end, but they've already lost too much, the NYM side. And it's just Michu left. So this is getting really, really bad now for NYM. And Forest going to finish things off with a quick AWP shot to Michu. And 6-1 is the score at the moment. And definitely, I did like your point very much, bringing in the poker terminology into it, because a lot of people, I mean, in poker, of course, there isn't quite the executional requirement. You can't really get like a headshot or something in poker, yet you can play the odds. And people tend to forget that there are odds in this game just because they can fantasize about that headshot that they're going to hit or that three kill they're going to achieve.
Right, if you're the MYM guys now, you have to play more aggressively, because at the moment they're playing a lot of default positions, and Nip doesn't even start a fast strategy. They just feel out what's going on, then they call a strategy based off that at the moment. Like, these are even default base positions for Nip at the moment.
Yeah,
because the problem is, if you don't play aggressively as CT, unless you're more skilled, if you're the less skilled team, you need to have the information advantage so that you can make your rotations faster and to the correct place immediately. Because if you're always lagging behind and they're going to outskill you, then it's almost impossible to win on a map like Nuke, because it's so much based around like getting into those 2v2 situations or getting a 3v2 that's favorable for you.
And again, talking about favor, they're a much more favorable position for Fifflerin just because they had the amount of map control that he could get into that position and gets an easy kill. MYM trying to find out information and NIP just abusing them for it. And now Innocent does get right, so that's at least something. But they've got a FAMAS and Infra 1S and is that a P250? And that's all they've got. But Innocent's going to try to make good with it. Does take that Fifflerin in. Can Michu get the kill with the pistol there? He's looking for it. Freiberg, though, in a great position. Gets two in a row. The bomb is there next to the Smoke Lord. Has to do this with the FAMAS, and he will. So it's very clutch right at the end there. That could have gone sideways. But MYM do manage to take down another round. So things are looking a little bit better. But still, on the money side, it's very, very fragile for them. They need to win a couple more. Really get
the thing is,
going.
For Nip, there's nothing to worry about at the moment. Even though you've lost these rounds, you've managed to lose two gun rounds, yet you're still at 62. Like, in general, everything's going in your favor. You're going to keep building up T rounds as it goes, because they're not going to rack up four in a row, you know? So at the moment, you're not worried. And as the MYM guys, I would be a bit concerned, actually, because they have had good rotations once they actually know where the Nip guys are. But a lot of this is just kills that's keeping him the round at the moment. It's not like positional advantage or knowing what tactics coming.
And I think this is one of those rounds as well. Threat used to talk to me about looking for situations where you might be operating at a loss, but you can make your completely screw over the money for your opponents. If you do something crazy, just get a bit lucky, then the CD side will be screwed over for the next few rounds. And this is one of those rounds for NYM. They're so fragile on the money that if they get a nasty situation from NIP here, things can spiral out of control rapidly. And NIP now have gotten control of the upper site. Another great frag coming from Fifflerin. And now Michu and Kowalski, last players remaining for MYM in this round. And they have a hell of a lot of work to do. And great play with the FAMAS there. I can never get the FAMAS to work, but Kowalski's got the moves. Takes down Fifflerin as well. And here comes Michu through the hut. Drops exist, and Kowalski with another on the FAMAS, and they get the defuse. Unbelievable, to be honest. Was not expecting that.
The thing about this game at the moment is it looks like MYM's, like, they're in the game, like, oh, maybe they can win a few more, but actually they're basically being carried by two guys at the moment. Like, one of their big problems is they're not getting much contribution from the others. And so, okay, if Nip keep hitting the right site and the right guys are left towards the end of the round, MYM can win the rounds. But I worry about what happens when those guys die first in the round. That's why I'm looking for the rest of the rounds here.
All right, so 6-3 the score now. And a bit more money for MYM. But to be fair, they did lose three players the last round. So again, still fragile. What are NIP going
to
do?
This is good.
Do?
A very aggressive push onto the radio room. You're going to immediately have information. And there's two kills immediately. Well, the second one didn't go through because it's a CSGO. But he's still got full information. He got a free kill. He knows exactly where they are.
And Fifflerin pushing secret, again gaining more control. They're being so aggressive there. Lord will make the trade though, and that's a 1-for-1 at the very least. Get right really, really low. It looks like they're grouping up for an attack onto the ramp room, and Michu's been doing well there so far. He's going to drop the bomb carrier, Forest. As he falls, exist will run through with the pistol, take Michu down. Kowalski's in a great spot, though, and they have full information on what NIP are doing at the moment. Kowalski going to fall back a little bit, though. Just let NIP have the ramp room whilst his teammates get the information, rotate to the appropriate positions to try to stop the best options from NIP, which currently seems to be like going for the lower site. We've got Lord in the corner below Getright, as we can see. So Getright with 6 health, he cannot make one single mistake. And Kowalski very defensive there in the window room. There goes Lord, takes down Getright.
Oh, and Exist wasn't sure initially, but now he knows where he is.
But only 7 points of health, and he does do it. Not even a single bullet going to be cast towards
Exist. Time's running out now, that's his big problem. I mean, he could actually plant here, but he doesn't know.
Well, he's going to have to try. He's actually going to come up straight through the vents, and great patience from MYM there. Very good patience. Going to help take the round down. So 4-6. I mean, if they can bring this back, not drop any more rounds, still they're in kind of a terrible position moving on to the T side, but it is something. You can work with it. It's a winnable position.
I mean, it's starting to get turned around. They're starting to get it going, but again, it's like all Michu for the most part. Like that round there was because he pushed up, killed one guy, got a lot of bullets on another one, and get to pull back with full health and taking almost nothing. And so that's like almost the best possible aggressive gamble you could take.
And here they go, running straight into Michu on the ramp, and he doesn't even get a single frag. It's all going to be down to Lord, who has to react by himself. He's going to drop down the ramp, move towards the lower side to try to prevent dying. He's got to survive. That's the most important thing. Eminize is there. He takes down 2 and the 3rd. Very, very good for Lord to survive there. And that's going to be 5-6. But now it's a buy round for NIP. AKs all around.
Yeah, this is the round that MYM has to win if they actually want to probably win this map. If they lose this round, this is where you can't give up any more rounds. And if you lose this one, you're definitely going to give up one or two more at least at the end of the half. So if you win this, you could possibly win out. So let's see what they do.
So interesting stuff here. Looks like they are playing a bit more. The pace has turned down from NIP so far. I was expecting something aggressive on yard, but they're just keeping it slow at the moment. Getright in position there, ready to flash through the glass on the upper side. So it looks like we're going to see the first big upper push from NIP as they rush into the site. They're scanning around for the players, and finally they will find Innocent on the floor. Trades, though, looking decent for NIP. It's just Michu left. He's been the man of MYM so far, but he cannot do it against Getright. And that's another round going towards NIP, making it 7-5. What's your take on that kind of delayed upper rush?
It was good by NIP. It was really badly executed by the CTs, though. Their setup that they had with a guy upper and lower, when that happens, you always have to have information on which way the person who runs first out of the hut is going. And so they let the absolute worst thing happen, which is that the guy who's lower got totally flanked and killed in the back, while the guy upper still was just looking at the hut. So he wasn't even sure that someone had come out and gone around like that. You have to at least get the call to the guy who was on the lower from the guy who's upper there.
And Fifflerin is going to be doing the usual that he's been doing so far. I'm just pushing to Secret, getting his frag onto Lord. There is another one close, and look at the reactions from Fifflerin and takes down Minaj almost effortlessly as his teammates sweep through the ramp room. It's just Innocent left, and there's really nothing he can do. That's another round to NIP as they start to really swing this back. MYM had a cute showing, you know, got a few rounds there, but it seems like NIP are returning the dominance. And it feels like, for the most part, despite perhaps, as you said, you know, maybe a less than optimal setup on upper and losing that round due to that, it seems like the execution, as you would expect, is just too much for MYM to handle at the moment from a lot of the fights we're seeing.
Well, just look at the scoreboard. That actually does tell the story to some degree. You had two guys on MYM who've put up big kills, who've had rounds where they've won the round for their team. Then you have three other guys who are getting kills on eco rounds, getting kills on the pistol, and they're not really contributing any actual kills. Well, if you can't stop people as CT and get a couple of kills on a round, then as a CT, you're never going to win the round because you're always going to be the numbers of disadvantage. You have to have one guy go crazy.
So what is your take on the new nuke that we're seeing in CSGO compared to 1.6? I mean, they're vastly different.
I mean, it's such a strange map because on one hand, you could say that, okay, I mean, the AK is so powerful in CSGO, you'd think that it would even end up more and teams would win more T rounds as it is. but it's still such a CT-sided map when the best teams play it, because of the fact that they actually speeded up some of the rotation times. Like, going through the vents is a lot quicker because the way you can run through them, you can just get down other certain areas a lot quicker. You can, they've got the secret area brings in a totally different component.
Here goes Piffling, just straight up rushing the secret area once again. Minaj from CT main does manage to take Piffling down though, and Kowalski gonna have kind of almost a crossfire for a moment there with Minaj, but it's gonna force NIP to just back off of Yard, but it's gonna be the push on ramp coming in. Michu's push to the defense does take down two players, and he is gonna hold the line as Minaj rotates around for the pressure through the back, through lobby, and Michu comes in for the cleanup. So that round looked really good, but we needed more rounds like that from MYM.
What really surprises me, actually, is that, I mean, NIP's winning, so they don't particularly care in this sense, but if I was NIP and I was trying to like play this like a math problem I'm trying to solve ideally, okay, then if I were them, after halfway through this first half, I would have just stopped going to the ramp room. Like, I'm going to go exactly the opposite position of wherever Michu is playing. In fact, I'm going to hit the guy who plays upper as much as I can. Even if I don't go upper, I'm going to at least take duels with him to draw him and get him to call players to come round. Because if you push into that ramp room, you're just taking like one-on-one fights with the best player on their team who's actually getting kills at the moment.
And here we go, we have the outside push coming in from MYM. Quick dispatch on to Get Right, and Lord also going to take down Forest. So they have gained a lot of ground all around the map, much like NIP did on their pistol round as terrorists. Here goes Piffin on the defense, does find himself a bomb. That could mean the difference. And actually, out of nowhere, all of a sudden, 1, 2, 3, 4, NIP, they just all win their little duels, and that's going to be the round for them. It was looking so good for MYM.
Here's something that's strange that people haven't noticed. So when the in-game leader was switched to Fifflaren from Exist, people assumed the whole point of that okay was like, okay, Exist needs to be like a star player, like go back to how he was in 1.6, more of like a middleman who can like go between being a support player and a star player. Actually, it seems like what they've done is made Fifflaren the in-game leader. He's taken over more of like some of the things Exist did. Meanwhile, Exist has gone to being the support utility player like Fifflaren used to be. And so that's where, in games like this, it doesn't matter, but you wonder how will that affect their matchup against the absolute top teams. Like, will that take away some of the firepower? Will Fifflaren be required to do more? Because the problem there you have to see is that Fifflaren is used to being the support player. That's his whole strength, you know. Indeed. You're not going to see him play certain positions if he's the in-game leader, because he can't die too early in the round.
It is quite an interesting dynamic how switching the in-game leader has massive implications on the playstyle, on the strengths. And I'd like to see someone make, you know, one of those little kind of boards with all the different, like, put a team there and put all their strengths, like their support strength, their just executional strength, stuff like that. It'd be quite interesting to see what the opinions would be. Get Lerpus to make one, and you can make one, and we can compare.
Sure.
And 11-6, so MYM definitely suffering at this point. Massively so, especially after losing their pistol round in that fashion. Just trying to get themselves some money. CZ75 is coming into play as Fifflaren is going to have to guard ramp against some aggression. And it seems like nothing to worry about for NIP, as you would expect on this anti-eco. Here they go, rushing through onto the upper side. All the NIP players stand still though. They are all alive, but here comes Minaj in the back. What is going on over there? It's like NIP will control the situation, almost looking a bit strange at the end. But yeah, it seems like, as you predicted right at the start, as most people would have predicted, it's seeming like a somewhat of an easy affair for NIP, to be honest. Where do you think MYM could really pick up the skill? You know, what is their biggest weakness that you're seeing, at least in this match?
I'm just really questionable about probably just skill level of some of the players. Like, some of the players seem just very shaky. In terms of, like, I mean, obviously, if you don't change the lineup, you have to just look at, like, team play and tactics. The problem is we're not going to get to see many T rounds here, so it's going to be hard to tell, like, what are they good at. As CT, I thought in general, yeah, they just played too passively. And when you do that against good terrorist teams, they just dictate the pace, and they will just abuse pulling and pushing you around the map, where they want you to be picking one spot and then just making sure that, because they get the information of whether you're there or not, they know exactly how to tell the other teammate who's not over there. He almost has like wall hacks, because he knows like, okay, there's probably going to be two people near me, or even better, there's no one near me, and then he can know how to react. You're not playing like just a pug here where you only have your information. which is what, unfortunately, a lot of teams who aren't like elite level, they kind of do play like that. You know, they play very individually.
It actually seems like MYM have taken control of the ramp area and are working onto lower, taking down Exist. Exist did nothing with his auto sniper. Fifflerin with the FAMAS is going to be at least taking one frag, but MYM are controlling the situation. Getrice trying to come in from Secret, and Freiberg is stuck over at Toxic, but what can he actually do from this position? Does take down Lord, but he's extremely low now, as is Getrice, but it doesn't even matter. Innocent gets dropped. Kowalski, though, going to get the trade onto Freiberg, as now that's a 2-on-1, but Getrice has no health at all to work with. And there goes Inay. That's going to do the job. So MYM do take the seventh round, and still quite a massive climb, though, especially on the T side.
Yeah, one of the big problems that this team will always face is that the reason why Lord was finally let go from the other team was that his biggest saving grace in 1.6, he was never a super skilled player, was that he was amazing in clutch round situations. And in CSGO, we've seen that support players in general don't win those as often. And so unfortunately, his strength was gone. And you've seen in this game, he never gets into clutch situations, he's never won any. And so unfortunately, he's the only star name on their team, and he's not a star in that sense, you know. And so the other younger guys, some of them are good, clearly. But I mean, I'm questionable as to what that guy was going to do with that weapon there, but...
Yeah, Forrest is just wrecking faces right now with the AWP, and Karski almost kind of gave his life to that. I don't know if he was trying to, didn't have an idea that NIP were playing it AWP outside, but it seemed like quite a play that he shouldn't repeat, let's just put it that way. And it's a 3-on-4 at the moment, and looking at the situation, we have the lower site contested, and the plant trying to go down through the smoke, but Freiberg is too smart to let that happen, as Michu does manage to take down Freiberg, but on a 1-on-2, there's nothing he can do, and that's going to be another round for NIP, of course, going 13-7, and I really am interested to see how Forrest plays this AWP now outside. I mean, Kowalski challenged him last round, got punished by it. I mean, with some smokes, though, on Nuke, if you play, are able to place the smokes correctly, AWPs outside, you know, they're not nearly as strong as they used to be in previous versions of CS. Looks like they're going to make a play on Lobby, though. Michu over in Hut. One AK. Rest have pistols. Just taking it slow over at Lobby still. Kowalski going to drop down to CT main. Spots Getrice. Getrice's going to easily dismiss him. So, I mean, you lose one player. There's four of you left. Options are diminishing. What is Minais to do with this AK, though?
Well, the big problem was the guy who went outside essentially now is giving his life for nothing because it wasn't a fake. They didn't go somewhere. And so now you just have a man down. Like, you need to use that. Like, I would make it so that as he drops down there, that's when you hit upper. So the CT's looking away from you. Something like that. You have to have some coordination if you want to make it work on one of these eco rounds. Especially because if you think about it, the guy with the AK was ramp anyway. So if he's coming in last and the other guys with the pistols swarm the guy who's in the little mini hut thing outside, that's how you get a kill, that's how you get an entry. Then the guy with the gun comes in, maybe he can then take a one-on-one duel with the guy above ladder. You have to kind of game plan it out in your mind. Like, I've always thought a thing in CS was, in an actual fight, you should never be thinking, you should only be playing instinctively. But in the 5 seconds before a fight and the 5 seconds after a fight, you have to very quickly come up with a game plan based on the limited information you have, then just execute it in the next 5 seconds when you take the fights. It's like right. Transitioning between those two positions is how the best players are able to do what look like, wow, what amazing coordination, but also hit the shots and have the skill and not be second guessing themselves when their technique of firing is underway, you know.
Yeah, Cooler actually often spoke to me about that very, very thought. And as I said, Fifferin just pushes straight into Radio, takes down Minais, and the rest of the MYM players are left just very, very far back, very little map control for them. NIP are starting to suffocate them in that regard. Getrice holding down CT main will take down Kowalski, so even less presence outside. Now the rest are all at ramp. They just have to go for this. Lord will take down Fifflerin, but Forrest is there below on the ramp. Can he do this?
Yeah, right.
Takes
it's
one headshot.
Position to kill that guy if he'd come up, and so he knows they're not going up. Huh?
It's just Innocent left now. And if NIP win this round, it's going to be 15-7, a very hard position to come back from. Don't want to go overtime against NIP, don't want to do anything like that. Innocent, though, does take down one more player, but still two to deal with. And Freiberg and Getrice I'm sure they're going to be able to play this well together.
Well, these are the two best clutch players, basically, on NIP. So these are the players you want alive if you're NIP. And if you notice how they're playing, they're basically just checking exactly the right areas. So he's going to get instantly killed when he walks out here, basically.
There you go. Indeed, always very hard a 2v1, especially against extremely seasoned players who know how to properly cover each other.
Right, on that particular round, you actually saw how NIP actually got a kill purely from communication, nothing to do with skills. So when Kowalski looked and saw Forrest was over at the secret, Forrest then just pulled back, but then Forrest told Getright, who was right over in front of the little hut entrance, the outside mini outer entrance, like, oh, there's a guy who's going to be over near that box. And so Getright was just stood looking at an angle and just got the kill as he walked across it. So even though those are like world-class players, that kill came only from communication. It had nothing to do with outskilling the guy.
And this could be the last round of this match between these two teams. As Forrest takes down Kowalski, there will be a frag onto Freiburg, though, to even things up a tiny bit. But it's still three versus three now, as Lord makes his presence known in the vents. The bomb, though, over at Secret. Which way is he going to go? There's only two players left for MYM now, and NIP are in good positions, actually, it seems. Fifthlerin has lower sight pretty much on lock. And Michu and Lord going to make the push through CT main, it seems, if Auto Director would be so kind as to show us. And here we go, now finally switching. The bomb dropped in main. It's very problematic. There is the GGs all around. MYM only managing to clock in seven rounds against the Titans. NIP, oh, I probably shouldn't use that word, as there is a team Titan these days. But the awesome players from NIP making a very, very easy game there for themselves on Nuke. So we're going to have Kick versus NIP next. Do you think Kick will fare better than MYM?
Oh, I think definitely. Actually, one of the things is Kick, I don't think they're a very good LAN team, but I think they're a team capable of surprising online. I don't think they're going to win, but I think they can make it competitive for sure.
All right, and we're just going to hit up a very fast break. Guys, when we're back, we'll have NIP versus Kick for Group A. So stay tuned. We'll be right back.